down in the DM.
It go down in the DM.
It go down, it go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down,
it go down in the DM.
It go down, it go.
Hey guys, welcome to the DM Talk Show, and today we're going to be embarking on a topic and of which all of us are gonna have an opinion on. So the topic is, you're messing with a girl or a guy but not serious, so you drop him or her and somehow your friend likes that person and your friend dates the person. Bro code, girl code, where do we draw the line?
Fuck that. No, seriously, fuck a bro code or a girl code. Like, if you like somebody, go for them, my bro.
Okay, so your friend was talking to the guy or girl,
yeah,
and wasn't feeling or whatever, then dropped her.
Yes.
Yeah, and then your other friend,
yeah,
likes the chick and whatever, and dates her, and they're going out.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that.
There's nothing wrong.
Firstly, the friend did not originally. There was no relationship there. First of all, they were just only talking.
Yeah.
So there was no necessarily strings attached there. So there should be no. There's no girl or boy code.
Exactly.
In there whatsoever.
The guy likes the girl.
Yeah.
And so obviously the girl didn't like the guy.
Yeah.
And so the friend likes the girl, and he asked the girl out, and she said yes. So it's your loss.
It depends as well on like. I suppose their relationship with that friend, you know, that friend might expect you to come up to them and tell them, yo, I'm feeling this chick you used to talk to or whatever. Can I make a move? Right.
Yeah.
But that's another thing. Do you have to approach that friend and let them know what you're about to do, or you can just move without saying?
But I guess just imagine the awkwardness.
Yeah.
The awkwardness of you, that he was already with her and now you went with her. Like, me and you, if we are so close friends, it's gonna be awkward to see the two of you together.
Okay.
While I'm there.
Okay, so what we're saying here is that I know that you were talking to her, or I don't know you were talking to her.
That's the question. That's why bro code. You know.
Okay.
That's what the question is.
But the thing is, they didn't date. You were liking the girl. You were asking the girl out, and she said no.
I thought they were together.
No, they were not.
They were just talking.
If they were not together, they were
just talking. Nothing happened. They were just talking. We don't know if they had sex enough or whatever.
I still think you should tell your friend though, because if you don't, if then next time he sees you, sees you guys together without any context.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? It could fracture the relationship a bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's just asking for a friend. Okay.
Okay.
They're sisters actually. So them both sisters, it happened that there's a guy who likes the younger sister, but things didn't work out between them. Mm-hmm. Then now, the guy went out after some months. Now the guy is asking out the bigger sister. And the bigger sister likes the guy.
No.
So what's going to happen there? Should you ignore your feelings? Or should you say blood is thicker than water?
Like that's your that's family.
Nah.
If it's so easy for a guy to change his mind so quick to a family friend, which means a guy can cheat on you while you're dating them.
What if he is the
in
one
in the family?
Sorry. So they were
what
just talking.
What if he is the one?
If he's the one,
they were just talking.
They were talking, but at the
nothing
same
happened,
time,
like
nothing happened. Really, nothing happened between them. No sex, nothing. It was just an intimate talk. You know them sexting stuff. Obviously, I tell my sister what's happening.
Yeah.
Obviously. Then the next thing, I tell her, you know what, it didn't work with the guy. Now, after some time, the guy likes this sister.
The sister really likes
the guy.
Yeah.
They really, really, genuinely like each other.
In that case, you
what's
approach.
Gonna happen?
In that case, you approach the younger sister or brother and say, yo, I really like the chick you used to talk to, blah, blah, blah. How do you feel about me making
what
move
if they
on
say,
them?
Huh?
If they say no,
No, you're still doing it.
what's the use? Asking them? Like,
because you're letting them know that it's gonna happen.
No, but then he's not saying letting them know. He's asking for permission.
I say you that.
If they say no,
the point is just etiquette.
That's another.
You don't even need to ask, because what happened was the guy went away and matured, and when he went
came back,
oh, I actually went to. And all the other
I actually want her sister.
Yeah, it was a mistake.
It was a mistake.
Yes.
So after you've grown up, you follow the
license. Bullshit.
But why? Why is that different from the friend? Why is it different?
The friend is nothing. No, I don't mean like a friend is nothing. Wow. But like family is tight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
A friend, you can lose a friend and get another friend, but you cannot lose a sister. Where are you going to get your
other? But if you are my sister and you love me, you have to also understand that there is what they call the one. What if he's the one for
don't
me?
Don't go after why must leftovers.
You, why must like, you waste the opportunities for me? It's an
it's not like you went hunting for the nigga saying, I'm going for my sister's nigga.
Exactly.
Feelings develop. Feelings
develop. You talk to your sister, I'm talking to this person, look at him, here's a picture, here's this and this and that. Obviously, you talk to her. And like, there's boundaries when it comes to family. Friends as well, there's boundaries, but friends, there's some rules to be broken, but not with family.
Nah. If there's boundaries, if there's boundaries, then how do you take this thing off? There are some cultures whereby if a guy is married to a young sister or to a big sister, if the sister dies, the guy has to marry the what? The younger sister. So how do you take that?
That's a shit culture.
Zimbabwean.
There are few cultures. No, not like Zimbabwean culture. There are some cultures that do that.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
There are some cultures that do that.
Sometimes with the clans. Like,
yeah, with the clans.
Imagine being a younger sister.
Exactly. You have to marry the husband.
Not my family, but there are cultures who do that.
Yeah, it's South African.
Okay.
No freaking
so what I'm saying is, family or not, one individual cannot ignore their feelings towards someone.
Yeah.
Plus, think about how hard it is to find a special
so
someone.
So in a way, it's okay.
You don't just find those around.
Guys, there's a lot of people in
it depends. It depends. What are your intentions?
There's a lot of women
exactly,
out there.
But the
I think it depends. It depends. It depends. What are your intentions, the guy? If it's just to just smash. Don't go there.
And they say they were texting. Obviously, when you like a guy and then you're texting for long, they were texting, weren't they? They were texting.
They were texting actually.
So obviously, you send a dick pic there. And then
is that what you do? Is that what you do?
I mean, sexting. That's what sexting is.
Listen,
you send videos.
I think
pictures,
we
do
it differently. Some
news, no?
Yeah, some of us
sex sexting. There's nudes, obviously.
Oh, no. I don't know about that. But what I'm saying is.
Well, you
it
know.
Depends. Oh. It depends. What are your intentions with that guy or girl? If they're just intentions of just smashing and that's it, I wouldn't want to go there. Mm. I wouldn't want to go there. But if it's something that I believe that I want more or something for it to be something very tangible, I will basically do whatever to see.
But there's no way of knowing the person's intentions.
Yeah.
But I think
like it's
say,
I'm talking about my own intentions. I cannot judge for someone else. I can't basically go for someone, because I can go for someone and not know what the intentions are unless they verbally tell me what the intentions are.
Yeah.
Guys, right? this
so
is
I can come up and tell you, listen, this is how I feel and this is what I'm hoping to get out of this. And then it's up to you to tell me if you want exactly the same thing or not. And then from there, we can then judge what are we doing.
It's easy to talk like this because like my thing is just like in the real world it's not gonna work, like because that uncomfortability of you coming home,
it goes away after a while.
No,
it
man,
does.
I'm with
it
your sister.
You can
it doesn't go away.
It goes away.
It doesn't go away.
The little sister was not serious with the guy.
Listen. You lose
what
the girl.
What if the little sister gonna take
you
a look
lose
again
the girl,
and then you're gonna
off,
be like
you guys are not dating anymore. Your relationship and your brother's relationship are broken. You like you just broke your relationship.
But why would the relationship be broken? You didn't want the guy. It didn't work out for you. Why must the relationship
be broken? But why don't you
get
another guy?
But it's siblings. If it's a friend, then
but what if the guy proposes to me or wants to marry me? Like he promises me all those things, and each and every woman wants.
What if he promised your sister also that?
So you are just blocking someone's blessing.
Never trust a man that's gonna go around your family. Ask your
blessings.
Sister out and ask her.
But the thing is,
never. Next time he's gonna ask your cousin.
My sister.
What she's saying is, if I can't have him, no one else can.
Exactly. Which is being selfish. That's being selfish.
I shouldn't even have him. I didn't have it. I'm just saying.
Then let it go.
Why are you playing over something you didn't have? Why are you playing over something you didn't have?
Do not ever trust the man in your life that's going to ask your sister out and then after ask you.
Yeah, but he went away. He grew up. He came back. And he was interested in
this. It mutually didn't work out. It mutually didn't work out.
In a month's time.
So because it didn't work out for you, it mustn't work out for everyone else. You're blocking people's blessings.
Let it all burn, is it?
You're blocking
people's
blessings. No. Family, friend, or God, whatever you are.
Now they have to meet up in secret and make it harder for themselves.
It's a scenario where it just doesn't work, where you'd be like, no, you can't have my friend, or like where it wouldn't be okay with you. The scenario
there is
okay.
There's a lot more of those than there is.
Which brings us to kind of the second phase of this is, if let's say that person did date for an X amount of time, now does the bro or girl code apply in that?
It does.
It does.
It's different.
Yeah, if they
but at the same time, it doesn't.
Okay, who believe it doesn't? Hands up. No. I'm not saying no. This is a simple question. Put your hands up if you think it's not a bro. It's not violating the bro or girl code.
When what?
No, the thing is, I'm in between.
My guy.
There is no.
If they ask a yes or no question, you're not gonna be like,
okay,
ah,
yes.
No, I'm honest.
You can't say
you want me to lie to you.
My guy,
say I'm one way.
Let
me explain.
No, I will explain. My question.
You
listen. I'm not saying you can't explain. My question is, pick your hands up. If you're saying that it violates the bro or girl code.
But what if you don't? If you have two people.
Just answer the question first.
Oh, okay.
Right?
They dated.
Yes or no?
They dated.
Do you think it violates the bro or girl code? Does anyone think it does?
Wait, are you saying
if you think it does or doesn't, I want you to explain. I want you to explain.
Okay, for me, it doesn't.
Explain why.
Why am I saying that? If I like the guy, my darling, I'm sorry if you are my friend. I love the guy. I like the guy. I want to have him. So what should I do? It's my thing. I can't be hurt. I can't have him last night. I can't.
You are on the same. You see that group? I finished them. You go on and do a
video. What if I want to finish the guy? What if I want to finish
the guy?
What if he's my only way? No, wait, Penelope.
He's going to go around and tell
Penelope, what if it's not always the guy finishing the girls? We can also finish the guys. What if I want to take revenge for my friend? We can also finish them.
No, you might think you ate me while I ate you. But society,
it works like that.
Even if we do stuff as men, but in society, if ever you go around like doing things like sexual stuff like a guy, at the end of the day, the society is going to call you a hoe.
Which society? We're not living with society.
I'm just saying.
My principles, my own thing. I do my own thing. If I want to finish the guy, I'll finish it.
She's finishing the guy. She's finishing the guy, whether you like it or not. Best friend, brother, whether what you are, is finishing. Finisher. Right? Now to you, what do you think? Are you finishing them all or anything?
Finish what?
What's your opinion? Is it a violation of a bro or girl code? What do you think?
Yes, if ever a friend of mine dated a guy and a guy would ask me out after then no. Okay. I won't do that.
Why? Repeat that again, sorry? No, repeat what you just said.
Okay, I'm saying if ever a friend of mine dated a dude and then this guy broke up with my friend and then he's asking me out, I will never date him.
Why?
Why?
Never, ever.
Never.
Why?
We'll catch up.
The question
now.
Is why?
Why?
Oh my God, why? Because... Like I value me and my friend's relationship.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, I don't want to be that group of friends where people are going to be like, yo, because men talk.
So you
live for people. What if your friend is like,
live for people.
Guys, whoever's feeling him, go ahead.
I don't live for
mind.
People, but like it's my value.
But what if your friend?
But
what if your friend?
Friends,
but what if your friend is like, yo, girls. Me and thing I've done, if you guys are feeling him or whatever, you know, walk away. I don't mind, whatever.
Because
are you still going to go ahead?
Penelope, do you know that women are more than men? Like in this world, you know that as women we are more
we
than
die
men.
A lot,
but you can find a man anywhere.
We do, we go to war more, we fight more, we die more.
Okay,
women
Yeah, but look at how many.
The police are killing you guys.
The police are killing us.
Hey, too soon.
Okay, okay. Okay, yeah.
Okay. Well, my point was. You're saying
you're saying men die.
So there's more women. I say
there are more women more than men.
Yeah.
And so with that on the table, I can't
die alone.
Suffocate. I can't die alone. I can't suffocate my feelings in the name of my friend once dated the guy.
Just because
you once
dated,
it was your time. It was your time. Now it's my time. Let me shine.
No freaking way.
God said no to
what
you.
What do you mean?
No freaking way. I don't see myself.
When God says
what
yes,
do you mean?
No one can say no.
Okay, what if it's the other way around? You let the guy go, but your friend wants and they ask you.
Ah, they can date them.
So, you see, you see now you're contradicting yourself.
No, but I understand her. She's okay with it, but she doesn't feel comfortable.
What if your friend is also okay with you taking
her? You're still going to talk shit anyway, because you're saying girls talk. You're still going to talk to her about it.
But with me, I will never date any of my friends.
Okay, so what she means is just keep your own opinion. Keep your own opinion.
Here's a question for you. You date a guy, yeah? You date a guy. Like, you start your relationship. You're talking to a guy for 6 months. You're dating for 6 months, yeah? And then all of a sudden, then what happens is,
guys, why do I feel like
your friend is like, your friend is like, hey, friend, I actually dated this guy, man, 3 years ago. How is everything? How are you gonna feel about that? Are you gonna cut that off? Let's say this is a guy, your friend has been dating before they actually met you or became friends with you. And then this guy's like, oh, friend, I actually dated this guy before, you know? Just makes a comment about it. How do you feel about that?
Ago,
are you cutting that relationship?
Three years ago.
It doesn't matter how long ago, but you didn't know about it. But now you know about it. What are you going to do about it?
While we're dating.
You're going out. You're in a relationship with the guy. What are you doing about that?
That actually happened to me, but like, we were not dating. Or I mean, we were like going on dates and stuff like that, but it wasn't that serious.
So you cut it off.
And then I found out that he dated a friend of mine. I cut it off.
How did you feel after that?
I was about to say this.
So you're telling me all those feelings just disappeared. So those feelings for that guy just disappeared.
I'm the type of person that can switch. If ever I put something on my mind about something, I can switch them off.
Oh, so that means whenever you are in a relationship, whenever you go into a relationship, you're already ready to switch it off.
If ever a situation comes, I'm ready to switch it off.
Why can't you find other means? I think we missed the point. That's her opinion.
It's my opinion.
No, I'm joking. I respect
you. Yeah, but listen, we can question
it's
your opinion.
Kind of value.
You should be able to fight your corner and not a
guy. Don't put me in the corner. There's something.
Yeah.
We're going
in a circle here.
Yes, for me, yes. Number one, but the thing is, because we were talking also about the sister thing of where, because this one is serious and the other one is serious. So I can't see you saying yes to the other one and no to the other one, because for me, that's contradicting yourself. Because for me, if I'm with a friend and they call you my friend, if you go and talk to somebody, I'm not gonna go there. That would be my number one point. My second point is, if the person was already with somebody, I would respect that person as my friend, and I would sacrifice myself and go and get somebody else. There's a lot of people with 6 billion people in this world. So I can go and get somebody else.
But what if that kind of a person is the one you like? What if that same person is the one you like?
If you are
so you have to sacrifice yourself.
If you are so addicted to like, you can go and like somebody else also.
So you've never done that. So you've never went for a girl that
you're so addicted to like.
So you've never done it. You never went for.
No, I would never. No,
people in the comments.
Because I would like to be respected the same way.
People in the comments would never tell us.
So you wouldn't want your friend to like the same girl you like.
No, it's awkward. You're not my friend. If you go for what I like, then
what
you're
not my
friend.
What you mean? It's not your friend.
You've never
been. So you end a relationship because of a
friends.
Girl.
Huh?
You end a relationship just because of a one girl.
Yeah.
Why? No, but context matters, no?
It does. No. That's my
that
opinion.
That means you don't love your friend as well.
In your opinion, is there no context
where, okay, it's I will allow it.
I will allow
it. You would allow it on both ends, where you have to let your friend go for a chick that you were talking to? You wouldn't let your friend do that?
No, it's up to him, but for that
you
action.
You wouldn't want that.
But what I'm trying to tell you, the action tell me, is this my friend or not? Because I've got my definition of friend. What is your definition of friend?
So that's being selfish in friendship in a way.
What is...
Because if I was a
what
guy...
What is your definition of friend?
Wait.
I think your definition of friend is two different
definition
things.
Of friend. Friendship is all about loyalty.
Okay. Okay. Now you're
good.
Talking about
yeah,
loyalty.
Yeah, I'm going there.
Okay.
Friendship is all about loyalty.
Yeah.
And if you are loyal to me and I'm loyal to you, you love me as a brother, I love you as a brother, right? Let's
no,
say I'm
sister,
a guy.
Sister.
No, let's say I'm a guy. I'm
oh,
taking,
you're a guy.
I'm, let's say I'm a guy.
Okay.
It's an example.
Yeah.
You like a girl.
Yeah.
Then, at the end of the day, things don't work out with you too.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I like that girl. Like, I genuinely like that. You can even see to me that I genuinely like that girl.
Okay.
Will you be that selfish for you to deny me the pleasure of going to ask her out?
No, but you can ask her out.
And eat.
You can ask. What I'm trying to say, I'm not saying I'm gonna deny you because I won't have that power. But what you just said, you said loyalty as a friend.
If your friend,
yeah.
We need to stop. We need to start this conversation. What is your definition of friend? You said
so,
loyalty.
No, no, no.
Exactly.
Loyalty. What is your loyalty? So that means that loyalty to you is that I can go to somebody that you liked.
No,
liked
I say to you, no.
Yeah.
Liked.
And I can be in a relationship where probably the two of you and
that's
I go against
you. Maybe you didn't get my point. Listen, Penelope, you guys didn't get my point.
I didn't like her.
You guys didn't get my point.
Just because you liked her now, so you're going to break our friendship.
My point was,
I'm your friend, yeah? And I come to you and be like,
for someone that's only there for
the girl you were talking to, I really like him. I really like
him. My friend
yeah, and I wanna try something with him.
Yeah, that means you became if you're not a friend, you
that
yeah, then automatically you are not my friend. You are somebody I know from
no,
that
no,
from
no,
that
no.
day on. You are somebody I know. You're not my friend.
Because I asked you.
Yes,
no,
please,
I'm not going behind your back or anything. I'm coming to you
as a friend.
And I'm saying, Victor, listen,
but
I understand. I want to see your own loyalty.
Which means you envy me.
I want to see your own loyalty.
Have my exes, have people that like me.
Penelope, I come to you. I'm
not there with me as a friend. You're there just to. For
anything. I understand. I understand your point, right? For my definition of friendship is loyalty, right? I come to you as my friend. I want to see how loyal you are. You see me, I'm dying for this guy. Like, I'm in too deep, my friend. I want to see your loyalty. Will you deny me the pleasure now?
Loyalty first starts when I talk to you, like, oh, look at this guy. So, which means when I've been showing you and talking to you, look, you see this one.
So, he's off limits.
I wish it was for me.
So, that guy is off limits.
So, he's off limits
because
you were talking to him.
The guy is off limits.
Now, he's off limits for my friend, the one who's been loyal to you for years.
He's off limits. What I'm trying to tell you, the moment you make that egg, our relationship definitely changed.
That shouldn't
That's
be
what
be
I'm trying
discussion.
To tell you.
That
he's there.
Period.
Go and get him. It's not a discussion. The
it's
thing
not
is,
a discussion.
I will not be very scared. I will be scared for
like
you in the future.
Or for you.
Yeah.
Either you're my friend
or
you're not. Or not.
I know. That's what I'm saying. If you do that to me,
so it's a violation.
Immediately,
so it's a violation.
You are not.
So
because I'll be scared what you are capable in the future.
So it's a violation. So it's a violation. Okay, to sum it up, it's a violation of the bro code for you.
You are capable of anything.
The fact that you even talk about it. Me and you already know the distance.
No way, no way.
This guy isn't my friend anymore.
What are these things?
Anyway, so for him, it's a violation of the bro code.
Yeah.
That's it. Let's move on. Omar, is it a violation of a girl code?
Guys, I'm going to say this again. Fuck a bro code, fuck a girl code. Honestly, because you're limiting the people in your life, you're telling them this is how you should live. Why? Life, it's not black and white, guys. It's very gray. If you like somebody that I used to date, what can I do? It's okay. It's life. It be like that sometimes. It's not. It doesn't mean, it doesn't impact our relationship, because at the end of the day you had the decency to come to me and tell me, like, you know what, friend, I like this guy. I know you guys were dating, whatever. Like, honestly, that means more to me than anything. If you were to do it behind my back because you thought something. Like, I want to create an environment with my friends where you can feel comfortable to come to me with whatever.
Okay.
And you don't have to worry about your...
Can I ask you a question? Me and you, we are friends, as you say, right? What if you've been talking to me about the same guy saying, you know, this guy is troubling me, I don't even like him, like, you know, you're talking to me, you're confiding, like, in me as a friend, you know?
Yeah.
Then at the same time, I've got an eye on the guy, you know?
Yeah.
Then I'll be like, oh, okay, fine. So since Wanga said she doesn't like the guy, that means there's no harm for me to what? Go for the guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're saying if you go behind my back, that's literally like going behind, not literally going behind your back. But at the same time, I'm not coming to you to ask for permission because you told me that the guy, you don't like him.
Don't ask for permission. Why?
You said, I don't need to let you know because you've already said it to me that I don't like this guy. Like, come on, he's troubling me.
Okay.
Then I go for the guy on my own whatsoever that I'm doing with the guy. Then I go for the guy. You see me with the guy. How will you react?
But this is what I'm saying. You don't have to ask me for permission, but I'm saying I appreciate you coming to me as a friend.
If I don't
telling me, you don't ask me for permission, you're telling me, friend,
mm-hmm.
I like this guy. These are my intentions with
if
this guy.
If I didn't come to you because of
but after
the fact
then
that
we can talk about
me.
We can talk about it after
later on. Matter. That means
we
it's
can
fine.
Talk about it after yeah, don't mind.
Oh, okay. That's
because
my
it's
point.
It's different than let's say I had feelings invested, even if I didn't for that matter. But like, you know when you like somebody, ne? You tell your friend you like somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And then your friend is like, oh, is it? And then it feels like they're being vindictive and they go after that person.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a friend.
Yeah.
Mm.
But if I tell you, all things considered, yo, I'm not feeling this guy. And you feel that person, go for it.
That's what I'm saying.
So, you don't need to come approach me.
You guys together and you're like, okay, this might be awkward. Come to me, tell me. Okay,
why should I come to you?
Why should I come to you? I'll come to you.
What is that awkward?
That's why
you said you don't like the guy. Why come to me? Why should I come to you?
That's why Victor was stating that.
I am not.
Look at the definition of differential.
I don't have a problem.
That's why Victor was saying friendship.
What is happening?
Friendship.
What is happening?
In the beginning. What does it mean to you?
Friendship. What does it mean to you?
What does it mean?
I understand that you're saying, okay, if your friend does that, they can come to you at least and acknowledge that you were there. And then Tandi says that, why does she need to do that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So which means that's why I said there's envy in between.
No
every
envy.
Time when I'm showing the pictures there, you envy my life.
There's no envy.
That's you.
There's no envy.
No,
but like, you envy the boy.
Is that how you envy? That's how you will
the
feel.
Guy?
Because you didn't get
yeah,
to.
Like, oh, I wish that was me. I wish that dude.
No
like,
way.
You know
what?
Like
guy,
the conversation was saying, the context of my friendships. In my friendships, I don't want to limit what a friend can be. If you like somebody,
go
fine.
For it.
I don't give a shit.
Okay.
It doesn't impact me. At the same time, you're still my friend.
My friends can date my exes if they want, but I would never date their exes. It's just
so that means you.
How do you feel?
What you're doing is Penelope.
It's just my principles and my values.
Okay. Fair enough.
In our friendship.
Does that change your views on your friends?
Does it change?
Do you still see your friends in the same light if they go for exes?
Yes.
Or is that friendship relationship still the same?
No.
Or does it change for you?
Because they
went for your ex. You said it's okay, yeah, for them to go for them.
Mm-hmm.
No.
So how?
Yeah,
does, so,
if ever they like
fine.
Them, they can go
okay.
for it.
But does the energy between your friendship between your friend does it change then, or does it stay the same?
Yes.
It doesn't change because the guy's gonna fuck them over anyway. Period.
What if they get married? And
trust me, a dude that goes around friends asking, he just wants to pay.
First of all, you said, people will say. So you, at the same time, that means you're not a good friend. Because if you're what I mean is, if you're saying your friend can date your exes, you don't mind. That means you don't fucking care about what people will say about your friend.
I'm talking about my principles.
Wait, it's your principles. I understand. That's where I'm coming.
Mm-hmm.
You, when you date your friend's ex,
mm-hmm.
right? You can't do that because you care about what people will say.
No,
but
I said those
that's
are
what you say. Yeah, that's your principles. I understand
and
them.
And the way
I
value.
And at the same time, your principles say, my friend can date my ex, I don't give a fuck. What about
if
what people say about your friend? You don't feel it.
what people say about my friends.
Yes.
Yeah, going for you.
You care about what people say about you. You don't care about what people say about your friend. That means you don't feel it.
But it has never happened.
It doesn't happen. But okay, hypothetically.
And it will never happen. You know.
Okay, okay, okay.
So what you're saying is, if it did happen,
I said what I said. That's what
I'm saying. What you're saying.
Say what she said.
Guys, it is saying, what it is. It's different that you have, but
it is what it is.
I am very confident.
Choose your friends wisely.
So, if that were to happen, those people aren't your friends. They don't make the
Yeah, choose your friends
no.
wisely.
No.
You will look at those friends and
there's
just
no, like with me, with this other guy, there was not even a conversation that I had with my friend. There was not even a conversation. I just heard from somewhere that he used to date this girl and whatever. When I saw the picture, that was my friend. There was no discussion. Me talking
how did,
to
how did your
friend
feel about that?
I just cut it off.
But you know what they're gonna know now.
How did your friend? How did your
no,
friend feel
obviously
about that?
After cutting it off, I told her, I was like, oh, we were talking about it.
How does she feel about that? Are you guys still cool?
What's no, my friend is married now. Like,
but are you
know?
Still cool
you
in
still
terms
cool?
of
yeah,
friendship?
Yeah, we're still cool. She's married. She's got her own life. We're still cool in terms of friendship. Cool, like tight.
Okay.
We're still cool.
Okay, but my question is, I don't think, this is my opinion. I don't think you'll look at your friends in the same light if they went for your ex. You wouldn't look at them the same.
Yeah, but yeah. Is it your ex though? If you were not serious with that person,
no, I'm just saying. I'm talking about an ex.
Put him in the.
I'm talking about an
no,
ex.
No, but ex are off limits. That's a different conversation.
Whoa, hey, he's always, no, it's his turn.
Right?
Go on.
So the initial thing was, if you were not really feeling the guy, and then your friend does feel the guy, then yeah, blessing. You're actually a better friend for letting them be together, right? However, if you were intimate with the guy. And it was going on for a long time, and then your friend does that. Then that is not your friend. That's not the same thing.
What do you mean? It's still your ex.
No, but like if it's like a.
Like it was.
Do you remember
a,
the question was they're just texting and sexting,
okay,
but nothing happens.
And you say you're fine with that, but you say you have a problem when it's like a
if there,
relationship.
Once you have already
not even established. They've slept together. They've
once
met their parents.
Thing.
As long as that has
she's
happened,
expired.
All these things about
my
it.
Question
it's
is
a different thing altogether.
What's
why?
What do you
why?
Say?
Why is it all of a sudden different?
Because
well,
I
obviously
think,
the
I think
thing is texting and the other thing is
handsy. Okay, you were texting whatever, but then you invested your emotions in that person.
Makai put
hands
on
it. Never happened.
No, you didn't. That's the whole point.
No, but
it was
you
like
can't
a nothing
tell.
Thing.
No. Okay, let's say you, right?
Kid.
Fine, you as a friend, you didn't invest anything. But, sorry, the guy, he didn't invest anything, but you as a friend invested something in it.
Okay.
Right? You were just texting, it didn't become physical or whatever, but then the guy was like, nah. I'm good.
Yeah.
Are you telling me that you're still fine with it or are you going to block it?
No, because that's different. Because that's my friend saying I have feelings for this person.
Okay, but
do you know what I mean?
If it's past tense, you had feelings for this person. The person doesn't have feelings for you, so reciprocated. So
okay, so
no, that still sticks because if there was an emotional connection to that person, even if it was before, if then now that person sees you with the guy you had feelings for, they're gonna come back and you're gonna feel some type of
thing. I think what it is, my
so
friend,
as long as you're emotionally
what it is
for
my guy is,
it's not,
if
when
there was anything,
stop, when
there
does the emotional investment not hold any grounds anymore?
Because people text all the time, they
when
flirt
does it
and
not,
they.
When does it not, like after how many months, after how many years,
it's
when
not
you
months.
Like, ah, it's fine. You can go for the guy, for my ex.
Okay, guys.
We're discussing
me, for
different.
Me.
I think,
for
I think,
my
we,
own point
no,
of
need,
view on
need,
this thing.
We need to wrap
it up. To wrap it up.
I hear what you're saying.
Hey, what's yours?
To wrap it up,
what's
guys.
Quickly, for me, if it's something, if it's someone you're talking to,
mm-hmm.
and there's nothing in it that was ever invested,
mm-hmm.
and I want to go there,
mm-hmm.
I should have a right to go there.
True.
All right? I should have a right to go there because nothing was ever,
Jesus,
nothing was ever tangible,
mm-hmm.
right? Nothing ever happened.
If there was
something happened, for me personally, that's a turn off.
Okay.
It's a turn off for me. I wouldn't wanna date someone that my friend.
What about
has
the other way around,
before.
Though?
Huh?
What about the other way around?
What do you mean? If it's the other way around, if my friend wants to go for
yeah,
I don't. For me, I don't have a problem with that, and I'll tell you why.
If
the reason
you had feelings for the girl.
If I still have feelings for her, then I'm gonna do whatever it is. Obviously, to still be with her. If I don't have feelings for her anymore,
no, you
what
have
do you
feelings.
What do you,
yeah. But they like each other. You have feelings,
I have
for,
feelings
her.
For the girl.
Yeah. but they like each other. She doesn't like feeling the same way about
you.
Me. Yeah.
In that case, then I'm not pursuing anything.
Guys, where
no,
are we?
No, you're not the one pursuing. The guy, would I let the guy?
Yeah.
Are we still on the
same
topic?
Yeah, of course.
And you're still gonna have the same friendship, but even though you know you still like the girl.
My guy, if the girl does not feel the same way as she feels about me, mm-hmm. there's no point in me trying anything with
her. But dude, that's okay. a lie. Yeah. You will never be the same with your friend because the
no,
guy.
No, he's just stronger.
He's wrapping up. He's wrapping up.
No, I'm just saying. Anyway, we're running out of time. As I said to you, just to recap what I said.
Yeah, let's just
if there was nothing tangible, I will go there mm-hmm. and I will let my friend also go there.
Yeah.
Okay.
If there was something invested before,
yeah,
I'm not going there. It's a turn off for me.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I would never do that. Yeah.
Okay.
Alright. If it's the other way around, where my friend wants to go for my ex, for me as well, that is okay for me.
Cut it. Mm-hmm. Cut him out.
That's okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So guys, we're done. Just comment, like, and subscribe, and tell us what you think about, you know, this topic.